On the starship Avalon, we believe your voyage should be as extraordinary as your destination. That's why we're offering our elite passengers a new level of luxury. 1,200 thread count sheets of the finest hydroponic cotton. 300 cubic meters of personal space. An unlimited water allowance. A library of over a million movies, series, and self-casts. If you can take your eyes off the best view in the universe. Elite suites. Only on the starship Avalon.
The Avalon, which is the spacecraft from the movie Passengers, uses a theoretical type of interstellar propulsion called the buzzard ramjet. It produces electromagnetic fields to collect hydrogen while traveling through space and then fuse the protons to create thrust. The problem is that, with this method, the spacecraft could only achieve around 10% the speed of light. It would take us 42 years to reach the closest potentially habitable exoplanet, Proxima Centauri b, an amount of time not plausible for a manned interstellar travel. On the contrary, antimatter rockets would be much faster. This type of rockets uses antimatter as a source of energy. Antimatter particles are identical to their counterparts, but the charge and spin are reversed. When particles of matter and antimatter attract each other and collide, a large amount of energy is released. Recent studies suggest that an antimatter spacecraft could achieve up to 70% the speed of light, reaching Proxima B in just about 6 years. According to the former Fermilab physicist Gerald Jackson, antimatter rockets could become a reality by 2050. So, what are the main problems of antimatter propulsion? On the one hand, producing antimatter is expensive. The price of 1 gram of antimatter is around $63 trillion. On the other, storing antimatter is difficult. The maximum time that antimatter has been stored is 405 days. Thankfully, all these problems could be solved. One of the most promising projects is called the Vacuum to Antimatter rocket, designed by Icarus Interstellar. This rocket would receive energy from the destruction of protons of hydrogen, which are the matter, and antiprotons, which are the antimatter. Firstly, the spacecraft would have to approach the Sun to charge a set of solar panels. Secondly, these panels would power a series of lasers. And finally, these lasers would produce electric fields to create antiprotons and protons. In other words, the spacecraft would produce antimatter directly from the vacuum of space, without the need of refueling. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing my channel. And if you want to help scientists make interstellar travel a reality, I recommend you watching this video.
Pandora, a world of wonder and mystery, incredible danger and strange beauty. From Earth's southern hemisphere, you can see the solar system where Pandora is located. Alpha Centauri. At a distance of 4.4 light years from Earth, the Alpha Centauri system is our nearest stellar neighbor. The largest of its two sun-like stars, Alpha Centauri A, or ACA to astronomers, is Pandora's sun.